A lot of my path into being a roboticist and a computer scientist comes from a love of video games. My parents essentially bought me this old video game, an Atari 2600, and I loved that system. And I was fascinated about how I could potentially make my own games. And that turned into sort of a love for computer science. The process of programming video games is the same process you do for understanding computers and programming computers. Once I became familiar about how to program computers, it started to turn into how do I make graphics and doing all sorts of things in virtual worlds. And then when I learned that, it was like, well, how can I do the same things in real worlds? And that turned my focus to robotics. We have certain goals that we want to accomplish, and then we take a set of actions to try and realize those goals. And the same holds true for robots, except that we as people program those goals into the robot, and we as people typically, you know, have already solved the problem for the robots. So if you want to have the robot to start to think creatively, what it has to do is figure out what its goals are, and there might be a space of possible goals, and what are the actions it could take in order to accomplish that. But how do you express the range of goals for a robot? How do you tell it, well, here's this new goal that you've never thought of before that might be reasonable to you? And that is just something that the human mind is able to do that is very difficult to express in terms of silicon and bits. And I can say, go here, and here is this XY location on a map. That's something that I can express. Good, society, being well-meaning, don't hurt people, those are things that are really, really hard to express. Last year, I was on sabbatical at a company called Willow Garage. A lot of what we worked on was how can we bring robots to the web? How can we make robots seamlessly available to everybody? But one of the most interesting of those projects was with a guy named Henry Evans, who's a mute quadriplegic.
Hello, my name is Henry Evans, and until August 29th, 2002, I was living my version of the American dream.
We took essentially a stock demo that we run in our lab where we can fly a quadrotor helicopter from his web browser. And we just took it up to his house and we said, all right, you want to try? Because he said he wanted to try. And we basically let him from inside his house basically fly a drone all over his house. Checked out, you know, the grapes that were girding in his garden. He chased his dog around. You know, it was a fun time. And so to see your work be able to go from the lab into out in the world and essentially helping somebody regain movement that he never had, that he lost, was a really incredible feeling.
Excited to be at TEDx Mid-Atlantic. Can you show us how excited you are?
Our job is essentially to build things, to build knowledge, to create ideas, even crazy ideas, and put them out there so that others can build on and others can develop the next generation technology, the next set of ideas. Everything that we've done in my lab is open source. So that's part of our message, our mission for knowledge dissemination. We've created, you know, code that people can use to fly drones. We make that available not just to people who are disabled but we also make that available to the whole world. It's really about bringing robots to the people. In terms of some of the current projects that we have, we're taking robots like the PR2. One of our goals is to be able to have it do things for people who want to age in their own home, and also people that are disabled, so they can essentially live independently. If you want to talk about interdisciplinarity, the Brown students are unique. They're different than what you'll find at any other school. They're going to bring a much broader interpretation. So, for instance, in the computer science department, I've had TAs that have worked with me that are studying computer science in Spanish literature or computer science in Greek mythology. It brings a perspective on solving problems that are different than sort of just the straight disciplinary way of solving problems. That is something you don't get at a lot of schools.